Praveen ji, you expand it a little more generally.
Sorry?
You expand the screen a little more. Now we are seeing.
After the prayers, yeah.
Okay.
I'll do that, yeah. But right now, I'm on a different device, so I don't know how much it doesn't fit in here. You can expand this much.
Yeah, good enough. Namaste.
सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने लोमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो मह्यं सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपयोः अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दुह्यत्तु निर्मलम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहन मत्तोन्यत इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये शान्ति शान्ति। We have to look at the tippana. So this sadrishya dosha has been refuted as hetu needed for adhyasa. Otherwise, the jatya adhyasa in atma wouldn't have been possible, but it is anubhava siddha to everyone that there is jatya adhyasa. Further, examples which were given. Is this in shankha, in the conch seeing yellow, although the conch is white, or after eating a particular thing the tongue gets some kind of the taste organs get biased in some manner that the jaggery tastes bitter. So these have to be adhyasa, because there is no yellowness in the conch and there is no bitterness in the jaggery. So they have to be adhyasa, and while there is no commonality between the whiteness and yellowness, the white and yellow colors, and the sweetness of the jaggery and the bitterness, but still there is anubhava. So they have to be adhyasa without having sadrushya dosha. So these examples were given. Now there is some hair split analysis on the example itself. We'll just look at it superficially, because like yesterday, some tika words are not clear. Even if they are not misprints, they are not clear at some places. As to the argument, sometimes is not very clear. So we'll look at whatever we can. Nanu shankhe pitima na adhyasyate. I think we saw the earlier one. Yeah, Saman, we saw that. Nanu shankhe pitima na adhyasyate. So the Purvapakshi is saying that the yellow appearance of shankha is not an adhyasa at all. So if you are bringing that as an example, I don't accept that as an adhyasa. So there may not be any sadrishya between white and yellow, but it is not an adhyasa at all. So it's a vishama drashtanta. It is not the right example. Kintu काच कामलादि दोष दूषित नेत्र स्थापित वर्णेन लिप्तत्वात् शंकः पीतो भाति इति चेत् न. सो हियर द आर्ग्युमेंट इज दैट द शंख इज सीन येलो बट इट इज नॉट एन अध्यासा. What happens at these doshas, which kacha kamaladi, dosha dushita netra. So the netras, the eyes are defective due to some disease. Kacha kamaladi, these are some particular diseases of the eye, cataract or some glaucoma type or something else. Whatever, here specifically, here kacha kamaladi will not, I mean, cataract or this thing will not bring yellow. It is basically a jaundiced eye. But it is given as an example because, you know, seeing two instead of one, that also will be covered by saying kacha kamaladi. So kacha is basically, I think that itself is cataract, but then others can be, there can be other joshas. So jaundiced eye is what we should take because jaundiced eye sees yellow. That's the phrase used in English also to explain that somebody who has jaundice sees, because of the defect in the liver, the eyes become defective and one starts seeing in a way the tinge of yellow. That is what is said. So here he says that is the netra. However, it is not an adhyasa to see yellow in the conch because the pita varna which is there, the netrastha pita varna. If you see a jaundiced eye, somebody sees somebody else's jaundiced eye, then one can see yellow in that eye, in those eyes. Yes, you see a yellowish eyes. Now that netrasthapita pita varna gets connected. So this is tarka, nyaya shastra viewpoint. Liptatvat, shanka becomes tainted by the yellow color. Now, some argument, you know, you should look at it from their angle also. So they say that the yellow color from the eyes taints the shankha, really it does taint. So it is not an adhyasa because yellow is there. Now, if I go and paint the conch yellow and I see it yellow, it is not an adhyasa, right? So similarly, it's like painting by the eye. The color goes from the eye and it paints the shankha. Shankha pita bhati iti chenna ghate khachitam ratnam suvarnadi lepo va tatkartuhu suvarna karadehe anyasya api yatha samameva pratiyate tathana sarvesham shankhe pita varna pratiyate. Now, I mean, this is obvious, but then at tarka level, you have to justify. They don't see, you know, anubhava is set aside, if you look at it. Unfortunately, Shruti is set aside, anubhava is set aside, and tarkikas wait only from logic. That shushka tarka does not work. So in Vedanta, every logic should trace back to, Vedanta. Meaning, it should trace back to Shruti. Shruti or Smriti. Smriti is also considered as a pramana, itihasa, purana, all of these are considered as pramana as long as they do not contradict what Shruti is saying. So tarka is also pramana, all right, but as long as it does not contradict Shruti. Bhagwan Bhashyakara or most of these Tikakaras or even this the work by Sadhu here or the Swami who writes the Tippana also, they will all try to trace it back and show that it has samya in Shruti and Smriti. Whenever tarka is used for argument, for discussion, but it is shown to trace back in Shruti and Smriti. If one cannot trace back also, it should not be contradictory. If the opponent can show that your analysis is contradictory to Shruti, then that tarka falls flat on its face. Such tarka is not pramana. Tarka which is in line with Vidvad Anubhava or Shruti Smriti Ityadi, which, so Vidvad Anubhava also, Anubhava also, which is not contradictory to the Shruti, is considered as a pramana, so to say. So this is the arrangement. However, if we have to use logic also, can we establish everything that the Shruti can do through logic? Maybe possible, but not really completely. Tatparya cannot be arrived at. Aikya cannot be arrived at by just tarka. That's why Shruti is a pramana. Otherwise, Shruti will lose its pramanya. You can have only one pramana for a particular source of knowledge. For knowledge, so for knowledge, for jnana, there can be only one pramana, one karana. You cannot say that I can see the color and so my ears can also see the color. For just like the way eyes are pramana for sight, we have to have dhrida nishchaya that Shruti alone is the pramana for Atma Vishaya, and in Vedanta, we are talking Vedanta. In Karmakanda also, Apratyaksha Vishaya. The Vishaya, Adrishta Vishaya, Apratyaksha Vishaya, for that Shruti is the Pramana. everything else, now this anumana ityadi logic also has its basis on pratyaksha. Without pratyaksha, tarka cannot work. Where pratyaksha does not allow you to conclude completely, there, based on some parts of pratyaksha, inference, anumana, arthavada, etc., these are pramana. So, example, stock example is Parvato Vanniman. In Parvato Vanniman, Vanni is not Pratyaksha, but Parvata has to be Pratyaksha. Only then you can say Parvata has to be Pratyaksha and Dhuma has to be Pratyaksha. So, if the smoke is not seen, one cannot conclude. Smoke has to be Pratyaksha, then only one can conclude that there is Vanni, Agni on mountain, on the mountain. So, it has a dependency on Pratyaksha. But this does not mean that even in Shruti, it does not mean that Shruti is logical. Shruti need not be proven as logical, nor do we say that Shruti is illogical. Shruti is beyond logic. So it is illogical. So it is beyond that. So this much we have to know whenever you use Tarka, even whenever you see in the Mula also, and in the Tippana also, any Tika or Tippana. The idea to show Tarka is to refute the opponent using his own tools. But it is not to justify the stance completely. It is to come back and show what the Shruti is saying. That is the idea of all, an aside of an argument also using these examples. Anyway, so Ghate Khachitam Ratnam Suvarnadi Lepova Tatkartuhu Suvarna Karadehe Anyasya Api Yatha Samamiva Pratiyate. If you look at the, all these the jewels stored in a pot, let's say pot or any other vessel or any, a locker. So if you have ratnas there, or you have suvarnadi lepahava, or there is a golden covering or something on something, one who makes it, the suvarnakaraha, the goldsmith, sees that because he has done it. Now the goldsmith who has kept the ratna somewhere, or he has made the ratna with a, say, gold coating or something, just like this yellow coating that taints is the argument of the Puro Pakshi. This lepa which is made by the goldsmith also is yatha samameva, anyasya api samameva pratiyate. It is seen so for everyone, not only for the suvarnakara. Whereas in the case of the jaundiced eye, it appears yellow only for the jaundiced, the person with the jaundiced eye. It is not that the yellow is going and tainting. So there is a difference. You may argue that in your system, the yellow goes and taints and all that. But if it is really tainted, the vastu, it is subjective reality. It cannot be subjective anymore. It has to be objective. Others should be able to see it. Others don't see it. So there is no tainting the vastu outside with the netragata pita varna. So that argument is not valid. Tata na sarvesham shanke pita varna pratiyate. This pita varna is not seen by everyone. It is seen by some. So therefore it is adhyasa. Kintu kachadi dosha dushita netrasyeva bhati na anyasya. One who has this kind of a jaundiced eye, defective eye, that person alone will see. Tasmat dosha dushita netrat pita varno bahir nirgatya shankena naiva sanyujyate. So, samsrujyate. So, there is no possibility also that this yellow color goes out and taints the shanka. Now, I mean, scientifically, this argument may not seem have any value, but then we have to see what are the philosophical viewpoints of others and how they won't work. Because not everything in Vedanta. Why not everything? Nothing in Vedanta should be compared with science, really. Because science is not going to make or break the philosophy. Philosophy is beyond science. So, therefore, Nayayika's argument also should be taken, you should not laugh it out. We should take it as a philosophical argument and see that it is, whether it is, against Pratyaksha or, Anubhava, then that argument is okay. But we should not bring in science and say that, what kind of an argument is this? Because our Vyavastha is also, the Vedanta system of perception has nothing to do with science. We discount science. We say that science is wrong there. So there is argument, even if there is an argument with a scientist, then we say that we don't agree with scientists as, you know, having an image formed in the eye and all that. We say that there is a vritti, and the vritti, the antakarana, goes out. So that is our system. We should not compromise that system for science either. Anyway, that being the case, apitu shankhe pitima pratitihi brahma eva. Therefore, it is not, since it is not seen by others, it is a brahma, because there are doshas involved, and that kind of a dosha with the eye has led to pitima brahma in the shankha. Nanu akashe paripatan pakshi yasya netra vritti sanyukta deshad urdhvam uddiya gataha. So now Puropakshi is bringing another argument. He says, I'll give you something else. So he wants to establish, finally his goal is to say that anatma in atma is not an adhyasa. That is his argument, and he wants to get in some example which will prove that without the adhyasa also these things are possible and they are satya. So using that, he wants to show that it is not an adhyasa, whereas Siddhanti is countering and showing as to how adhyasa is a possibility, and then finally not only a possibility, that's the only possibility. So this is the Siddhanta's view. We have to see what is the approach, otherwise we can get lost in examples at their level and we don't know how it connects to the exemplified. Anyway, nanu akashe paripatan pakshi, a bird which is flying in the sky, yasya netra vritti sanyukta deshad urdhvam uddiya gataha. So the bird which is, you know, is there, and it is clearly seen to one person, he is watching that bird, another is not watching. This bird flies. Now as this bird is flying, when it is close by, you can clearly see. And when it flies in the sky, unless you trace that bird's flight, you may not be able to find out where is the bird, because it has grown so tiny and far, because of going far, it has grown so tiny, grown as in from the vision, the size of that bird appears to be so small being far that it is not easy to find out without tracing its flight. You should be tracing its flight, then only you can see a small bird somewhere, you see a small dot in the sky which is flying, and you know that it is the same bird that I have been tracing when it flew. So very interesting example. Nanu akashe paripatan pakshi yasya netra vritti sanyukta deshad urdhvam uddiya gataha tasyaiva kevalam bahudura gamana paryantam anusrutya pashyatah vishayi bhavati na anyasya. He says it appears to the person who has been tracing its flight, not to the other. Somebody, you know, suddenly looks in the sky, he'll not see the bird. It's a dot in the sky, he'll not be able to see the dot, and he will not, definitely not know that it's a bird. But the argument is, he'll not be able to see the bird in the sky, while another who has been tracing the flight can see it. Evam yasya netra stapita varno lipta shanke tasyeva param upalabhyate saha. So now he's saying, similarly, this yellow color which one has been tracing, as though tracing from his eye to the shanka, to him it appears, for the others it does not appear. The other who has been seeing, who's not been tracing this yellow color tainting the shanka, very interesting argument, what kind of philosophical thoughts go behind a philosophy we know. Not everyone thinks in this manner, It is a possibility, the Puravapakshi says, that the person who has this jaundice, he has yellow color in his eyes, that yellow color is going and covering that. Now that it has covered, you cannot see. But if you had you traced it from the eye to that, meaning the person who knows the yellow color, his eye is tracing the yellow that goes out from his eye and falls onto the shankha. Whereas the other who is not seeing, he will not see, definitely not see. So that is the argument. Therefore, in this pitima, it is not a brahma. In the example of the shankha that you have given, it is not a brahma. It is really there. The other cannot see because he has not traced the yellow taint. He has not traced the yellow is not followed the yellow color. Evam yasya netrasthapita varno liptah shanke tasya eva paramupalabhyate saha savarnaha na anyasya iti chet. If that is the argument, no, na. Akashe paripatan. So using the second example, he is establishing the first example of Pitima as not a Brahma. Because in the other case, in this argument of others cannot see. It's just like in the bird. So he has brought in another example. Now the Siddhanti is saying how it is not valid because your example to establish that in the flight of the bird also won't work. Even yasya, so not even, akashe paripatan pakshi, yasya netra gochari bhuta desha durdha muddiya gataha, sa eva anyasmai tam angulya nirdishya darshayiti chet, para api tam pakshinam pashyatyeva. So in your example of the person, let's say Devadatta is following the flight of the bird, and when it became a dot in the sky, Devadatta can see, Yajnadatta cannot see. However, if Devadatta shows Yajnadatta, look at that dot there in the sky, do you see, using Shaka Chandranya or whatever, you know, if he is able to point out and show that that's a bird, then Yajnadatta can also see the bird. It is not that only Devadatta can see. So now in your exemplified also, the yellow in the Shanka, let the jaundiced eyed person show to the other. Let's say the jaundiced eye person is Devadatta, he is seeing yellow. Let him show that this is yellow. Does the other see? No. So your example, second example to prove the first one, falls flat. Sa eva anyasmi tam angulya nirdishya. So having shown with the pointing with a finger, if he shows, then the other also can see the bird. But similarly, the other cannot be shown the yellow color in the Shanka. Natu evam shanka pitima varnaha angulya nirdishya pradarshitopi parasya upalabhyate tasmat shanke pitavarna satyaha kintu na satya tasmat na shanke pitavarna satyaha kintu adhyasta eva. Therefore, in the Shanka, Brahma is established. Itham shanka pitim adhyasa antarena eva sadrishyam utpadyamanaha api sadrishtanta shanka samadhanabhyam eva siddhyati ityataha nirvivada drishtantam darshayiti gude tiktati iti. So itham, in this manner, shanka piti va adhyasa antarena eva sadrishyam utpadyamana api. Although this shanka having this yellow color is shown to be an adhyasa, which is possible without sadrishya, because yellow and white have no commonality. Of course, I mean, you cannot argue that both are colors. We know both are colors, but between the colors, there is no samya, sadrishya. But still there is a pratiti, therefore that pratiti is a brahma. It is not a prama. It is not satya. It is adhyasa. Even then, sadrishtanta shanka samadhanabhyam siddhyati ityataha. Since that kind of a, why did he give the jaggery example? That jaggery may taste bitter after eating something, and that bitterness in jaggery is a Brahma, because there is an argument. This argument that has been made is with the yellow, and the Purvapakshi has some question. Since the doubt can be taken only after a length of discussion that we saw today, therefore another example is also brought in. Sadrishtanta shanka samadhanabhyam eva siddhyati. So drishtanta, this drishtanta of the yellowness in the shanka is established only by the shanka samadhana, shanka and samadhana. Therefore, nirvivada drishtantam darshayati. Where there is no argument, in gude tiktata, there is no argument at all. So there, that example can show that Brahma is possible without sadrisha. So it is a better example, since there is no argument. Whatever is acceptable to the Purva Pakshi and to the Siddhanti is the best example. Where there is no acceptable sense, there is no vivada also. Okay, so with that, let's go to the 95th point there. Sorry, you're already on the next page. So the 95th avartha says, pramatra doshopi na avashyam adhyasa hetu. So pramatra dosha is not mandatory for the adhyasa as hetu. It is not mandatory. Pramatuhu lobhayat. Pramatuhu lobhayadi dosha. Pramatuhu lobhayadi dosha na adhyasya hetava. So Purvapakshi had said pramata. The pramata who is seeing. Say in Shuktika he is seeing rajata. There he has rajata lobha. Rajata lobha being there, that becomes the dosha, which becomes the hetu for the adhyasa. And in your exemplified atma and anatma, there is no such pramata dosha which makes him see the ahankaradi dehanta in atma, meaning seeing bandha in atma, anatma in atma. Where is this lobhadi dosha? That is not there. So it is not true that lobhadi dosha should be there in pramata for adhyasa. No dosha is needed. Without the dosha also, pramata dosha, here pramatra dosha, without the pramatuhu dosha, in samasa pramatra dosha, that is not needed. Why? Because lobhadi shunya viraktanam api shuktikadav rajatadhyadhyasa darshanat. Because a sannyasi or someone virakta, one who does not have any desire for wealth, he will also see a shine, and he may also get confused that the shine that you see in on the seashore in a shell, that the akara is golakara, it is like a, it appears like a silver coin. One may, there is a possibility of silver coin also. So that Brahma is possible for those who are vairagis also. It is not true that pramatu lobha is there. The vairagi does not have any lobha, and he still sees silver, therefore it is an adhyasa without the dosha such as lobha ityadi in the pramata. Okay, so parapaksha ritya, parapaksha, this purvapaksha, parapaksha is purvapaksha, opponent, parapaksha ritya dosha rupa hetva bhavatna adhyasa jayeta. However, in the purvapakshis, parapaksha's argument, dosha rupa hetu needs to be there in the pramata dosha rupa. If it is not there, then adhyasa is not possible. Tasmanna pramata dosha adhyasa hetu. In the purvapakshi, if the purvapakshi says dosha should be there, pramata dosha should be there, without that pramata dosha there cannot be adhyasa, but adhyasa is seen, therefore purvapakshi is wrong. That is what is said here. Tasmanna pramata dosha adhyasa hetu. Now the another dosha pointed out is pramana dosha. So pramana should be faulty. Pramana dosha api na avashyam adhyasa hetuhu. Pramana dosha api na adhyasa hetu. Why? Example, which I mean the argument given by Purvapakshi was that pramana has to have some dosha. So here this jaundiced eyes had being looked at. Tathahi sarvesham eva nirupe akashe nailyam nailyam indra. Nailyam Indra Neela Kataha Karakashcha Kataha Karashcha. Sorry, Nailyam Indra Neela Kataha Karashcha Bhati. So Akashi Nailyam Bhati, that is the idea. Akashi Nailyam Bhati and Indra Neela Kataha Karashcha Bhati. Basically, the idea is you see, you know, a bluish sky. Indra Neela. So Indrasya Varnaiva. So Indra has, it's said to be Indra is Neela. So similar Neela, that kind of a Nailya is seen in Akasha. But Akasha does not have that blueness in the sky. And you see a dome shape. Kataha Kara, there is a dome shape seen in the eye, seen in the sky. Now that dome shape is not there. Sky is shapeless. Sky is colorless, but still there is a bhranti, adhyasa in the sky of Nailyam and Katahakara. There is bhana, pratiti is there, but it is not satya, it is adhyasa. What is the pramana dosha there? Is it like the jaundiced eye? Jaundiced eye sees yellow is fine, but here everyone sees this Katahakara. Everyone sees a dome shape in the sky. When one looks up, you see the sky is as though curved, as though dome. Everywhere you see up, you see in any direction upwards, and you keep on turning, the sky remains like a dome shaped, like an umbrella above your head, you know. So you have a lot of these, you know, like an umbrella, There can be songs made. Why? Because there is a common experience. It's an objective experience. Cannot be negated by anyone. And you cannot bring in dosha. You cannot say every eye is faulty. If every eye is faulty, then it is not a fault at all. It is a feature. It's a characteristic. So it's a human characteristic to see the dome shape. That cannot be shown as a flaw per se. In the argument, such as a jaundiced eye sees yellow. Tataha sarvesham akashe samataya nailadhyadhyasasya jayamanatva sarvesham netrendriya pramane pittadi dosha sadbhava kalpana vachya. Now, if this pramana dosha is needed, mandatory for adhyasa, then pray tell what is the pramana dosha in everyone seeing this dome-shaped akasha or nailya in akasha. There is none. Vachya, it has to be. This kalpana has to be done. Pittadi dosha sadbhava kalpana vachya. Netrendriya pramane. Because one sees in using this pramana called the netrendriya, you show me a flaw in that pramana as to why, just like this pitta dosha. Sadbhava, similar kalpana should be made in this case of the sky being seen as blue or as dome shaped. Vachyas. Sacha nanjasi. But that is not valid. You cannot show any valid dosha in the pramana. Netra. For everyone. Sarvesham. Tasmat pramana doshopin adhyasayetu. This pramana dosha is not needed at all. Just because it is there in the yellow color seen in the shankha for a jaundiced person, there is a netra dosha, all right. That may be a cause also, but it cannot become a rule that just because in one particular case, in adhyasa, yellow adhyasa, there is the colored eye is the reason, is it, that dosha becomes the karana. It is not necessary in every case. So it is not a samagri at all. So, tasmat pramana doshopi nadhyasa hetu. Akashe nailadhyadhyasa vishaye na kevalam pramana dosha bhavaha kintu sarva dosha bhava api. Now, akashe nailadhyadhyasa vishaye. In the akasha example where you see nailya ityadi, the dome shape or the bluish color, na kevalam pramana doshasya bhava. Not only the pramana dosha is missing there, kintu sarva dosha bhava api. There is neither sadrishyam nor pramana dosha. So we should not say neither nor, none of the doshas are there. So none of the sadrusha dosha is not there, pramatra dosha is not there, pramana dosha is not there, then prameya dosha is not there, akasha does not have dosha. And finally the last dosha which we discussed, that none of these doshas are there. Five doshas you have pointed out as samagri for adhyasa. In akasha example, it is so clear that none of these are there, but still there is adhyasa. So why? Because akasha is so subtle, it is very easy to mistake for a lot of things. Attribute a lot of things to it. In akasha, there can be a bad smell attributed to pot space if you keep lasuna ityadi. You know, you keep garlic, there is a garlic smell. That smell is there in the pot, but it does not accrue to the space. It does not affect the space, but still we say that, oh, you know that particular area, it is stinky. It is not the akasha, the area is stinky, in a sense the akasha is stinky. That is the statement. It amounts to that kind of a statement, but it is not true. So many things are can be shown with akasha. So, akashe sarva dosha abhava. So, kevalam pramana dosha abhava na. Kintu sarva dosha abhava api. There is each and every dosha that you point out is missing in this akashe nailya adhyasa, etc. Sadrishya abhava pramatra dosha abhavascha tatra siddha eva. Sadrishyam is not there. Pramata dosha is not shown, cannot be shown pramatra dosha in this example of akasha. Yatha sakala dosha bhave api akashe nailadhyadhyaso jayate tatha atmani api bandhadhyaso dosham vina eva jayate. Dosham vina eva jayate. Similarly, now if you can see one example, a possibility of adhyasa of Nailya Katahakaraha in Akasha without any of the five doshas which you have brought up, O Purvapakshi, then you have to accept the possibility of without Sadrushya, without Pramatradi doshas, there is a possibility of Anatma Bandha Adhyasa in Atma without any Samagri such as these five doshas. So forget all five as mandatory. None of the five are mandatory. Yatha Sakala Dosha Bhavi Api Akashe Nailadhya Dhyaso Jayate Tatha Atmanyapi Bandhadhyaso Dosham Vinayeva Jayate Tasmat Dosha Bhavad Bandha Adhyasa Rupa Nabhavati Itiyam Shankana Yukta. Therefore, the Purvapakshi argument which he began by giving a long pravachana, none of that is valid. That doubt is not to be entertained, that without the dosha, bandha, this bandha which is an adhyasa is not possible. Bandha in the form of the adhyasa is not possible. Therefore, the Purvapakshi has erroneously concluded that bandha is satya. His conclusion is wrong because his basis is wrong, that doshas are needed and dosha abhava is the reason for bandha to be satya. That kind of a thinking is wrong and the doubt that he has raised is not tenable. Yata sarva dosha virahe satyapi akashe. So dosha virahe satyapi akashe nailadhyadhyaso jayate sakala purushanam tasmad doshan adhyasa hetu. So sakala purushanam, for everyone, without any dosha, this nailadhyasa is possible in akasha. Although there is no dosha at all, sarva dosha viraya means none of the doshas being there, also each and every person sees nailya in akasha, and therefore dosha is not adhyasa hetu. Pittadi dosha shunya netrasya api akashe indra neela katahadyakaro bhasate. So one who does not have the jaundiced eye or cataract or whatever, you know, glaucoma or any other dosha in the eye, even that person sees the bluish sky as well as the dome-shaped sky. Tasmat pramana doshana adhyasa hetu. Therefore, it is established that pramana dosha is not adhyasa hetu in 96th avartam. Itham doshana adhyasa hetu. Pramana doshopi na adhyasa hetu. Further, this is which page? Looks like a disconnect. 58 and then 59. Okay. Ittham doshana adhyasa hetu. Now, he says, ittham, in this manner, doshana adhyasa hetu. Dosha itself is not adhyasa hetu. Now, this is a statement, a very bold one. So, Tippanakara has an argument with Sadhu himself. The author has made a very bold statement, ittham dosha na adhyasa hetu. This is a very generic statement. The doshas which have been pointed out by the Purvapakshi, they are all not necessary for adhyasa. That is fine. But specifically saying that no dosha is needed. Broadly, it can be taken that when every person or every jiva has some pratiti. Now this, we are coming to the Atma Vishaya. Whenever there is a pratiti for everyone, what is called as objective reality, there it cannot be considered as an adhyasa. This is the Laukika view. But Vedanta says that there is adhyasa. It is all adhyasta. If it is said to be adhyasta, then adhyasa needs to have a karana. There has to be some karana, and that karana itself becomes dosha. So if this statement is to say that no dosha is needed, such as ajnana, avidya, none of this is ajnana or avidya with its shaktis, avarana shakti and vikshepa shaktis, they themselves are doshas. So if the author is saying that those doshas are not needed, then it is debatable. Obviously, it is debatable. That is not the Siddhanta. But the author may not mean it in that way. because I mean he is he is a scholar as well as, you know, a traditionalist who knows Vedanta in and out. We can see even from the second chapter, we have seen the kind of arguments he has made. He has Panditya of a very great order. And obviously Anubhava Siddha, this will be seen in the third chapter, why it is Anubhava Siddha. So he, it is Vidvat Anubhava Siddha to him as well. Therefore, he is not making that statement, but why did he make it seem so? There is a discussion here as to, we'll finish this and then look at Tippana. Ittham dosho na adhyasa hetu, ataha bandhadhyase na dosha apeksha asti. Dosha apeksha nasti bandhadhyase. This is the statement he has made in conclusion that no dosha is needed for bandha to be adhyasa in atma. Anatma to be adhyasta in atma. Sankshepa sharirake. Now, this is the bold statement. Sankshepa sharirake bandhadhyasa prastave dosha api karanatvena uktaha. In the Sankshepa Shariraka, a work which is Sankshepa, it is brief, brief in a sense, it is quite a large work, but brief in comparison with Brahma Sutra. Shariraka Sutras, Brahma Sutras are called as Shariraka Sutras. So in Brahma Sutras, there is a Sankshepa Shariraka. That is Sankshepa in comparison to the voluminous Brahma Sutra. Therefore, it is called as Sankshepa Shariraka. In that work, in that section called Bandhadhyasa, the discussion on Bandhadhyasa, in that Bandha being Adhyasa, dosha has been mentioned as a karana. Grantha Vistara Bhayat Neha Sa Nirupitaha. Now, this can mean two things. That particular dosha is said to be a karana in Sankshepa Shariraka. Means that it is out of scope of discussion for this work. So, if you are interested, please go ahead and have a look there. So, this can be a statement of agreement. It can be a statement of disagreement also, because he said dosha na adhyasehetu. So, it looks like the Tippanakara, the Swamiji is reading that he does not agree, because he has said sankshepa sharira ke bandha adhyasa prastave dosha api karanatvena uktaha. So, there is a possibility that he disagrees. As in, the author disagrees, sadhu disagrees. This is a possibility as seen by the Tippanakara, in my opinion. Why so? Because, in Vyakarana Sutras also, those who have studied Ashtadhyayi, you know, use lopa shakalyasya. So, if you have lopa shakalyasya, shakalyasya matena lopaha vidhiyate. Natu paninina matena. So, panini... Panini Mata, which is there. In that Mata, Paniniya Mata does not have that. This is the idea there. So when you say Lopa Shakalasya, Panini Maharshi does not agree with it. That is how the, because after that there is, you know, Lopa Shakal, then Hali Sarvesham. So when he says Sarvesham, it is agreeable to everyone. But Lopa Shakalasya is specific. So when Lopa Shakalyasya is said to be with a rishi's or some other Vayakarana's name, it has been put Shakalyasya Matena. That means Panini Maharshi does not agree or others do not agree. At least that much has to be seen there. Similar seems to be the analysis here as to why dosha is said to be in Sankshepa Shariraka as a karana, but here it is not said. So Grantha Vistara Bhayat Nahya Sa Nirupita, that dosha is not discussed here. So to me, it appears that dosha is agreeable. But, you know, right now, if we discuss all that in the Anubandha Chatushtaya Vistara, you'll have so much of discussion there that this grantha will become bulky. Dosha yadi adhyasa hetur bhavet. However, now this is the clincher. Dosha yadi adhyasa hetu bhavet. Tada tadvishesha vicharo yujjeta. So had dosha been a hetu for adhyasa, then alone vichara is valid. So it is not only grantha vistara bhaya, but it is also this vishesha vichara is not needed as per the author, because dosha is not an adhyasa hetu. Tad asambhavadeva, tarasambhavat means tasya asambhavat. doshasya asambhavadeva neha sa prapanchate. So he does not agree that this dosha is the reason for adhyasa. All this may come up later because right now he is not talking about this dosha as an adhyasa hetu at all. We'll see why as the grantha progresses. But here the Tippanakara mentions what is this viewpoint for. Why has he made this in the two lines? Why does he say that Sankshepa Shariraka says it? But here initially adhyasa hetu is not, dosha is not an adhyasa hetu. Then he says Sankshepa Shariraka agrees that it is a karana. However, he says that it cannot be a karana. Only had it been a karana, he says asambhava. The dosha is asambhava. Actually, if you look at it, dosha ajnana affecting Brahma is impossible. That is what is being said, really. So, what he is saying is that the ajnana does not affect Brahmatma. This is what we should take it at as a samanvaya between the Sankshepa Shariraka and the author of the work. This is the samanvaya. I prefer this samanvaya. And in the tippana, you see, it's a long tippana. We'll just go through it. Atra idam avagantavyam. This should be understood here, says Swami here. Nikhila dosha samavaye sati eva adhyaso jayeta iti niyama bhave api yatkinchit doshe sati eva adhyasa sambhavati iti vaktavyam. Although these doshas as brought up by the Purva Pakshi are not the hetu for adhyasa, they have to be refuted. That niyama is not there. Niyama bhave api. Although such a rule is not there, as all these doshas which have been pointed out by Purva Pakshi need to be there, or any one of them also is not valid for doshas, still yatkinchit doshe sati eva adhyasa sambhavati iti vaktavyam. Because adhyasa means superimposition, projection, that is possible only kalpita, it is kalpita. So kalpana, some dosha has to be accepted. Some dosha, yatkinchit, it is not a dosha, but it is dosha iva dosha. That has to be accepted, is the siddhanta. Yadapi akashe nailadyadhyase na kopi dosho drishyate ityuktam tatrapi ayam ashaya. Even if it is said that in nailadhyasa, nailyad, this the dome shape in akasha, there is no dosha involved. It has been boldly said, none of these doshas that the Purva Pakshi pointed out are not there. Still, some dosha has to be accepted. What is the idea there? Tatrapi ayam ashaya yasmin adhyase hetutvena sadrishyadi rupa vishesha dosha kopi na apekshate tatrapi avidyakhyo dosha apekshata eva. There avidya has to be accepted. You know, the sun rises in the east and sets in the west. There is an adhyasa. There the one does not know. One does not know that. At that point of time, one is not thinking. You know, scientifically, one knows that the sun does not rise or set. Still, there is a pratiti. During the pratiti, one gives into the pratiti. However, if one understands science and keeps in the mind, it will still be an appearance. But there will be no adhyasa. Adhyasa as in, it is not, one does not misunderstand that the sun is rising. As a phrase, one may say the sun rises at this time and all that. But one knows that the sun neither rises nor sets. But one who does not know, he will claim that the sun is rising. So that is the difference. Here also, in akasha, nailadhyadhyase api, akashe nailadhyadhyase, sarvata doshave adhyase evana sambhavet. Yasmin adhyase hetutvena sadrishyadi rupa vishesha dosha kopi na apekshate, tatra api avidyakhya dosha apekshata eva. There avidya should be considered as a dosha. Sarvata dosha bhave adhyasa evana sambhavet. Because adhyasa is not possible if no dosha is there. There has to be accepted. You know, some dosha, even if you cannot point out what exactly it is, something should be accepted. Because you are calling it as an adhyasa. That is the argument of the Tippanakara here. Akashi nailadhyadhyase api vishesha dosha traya anapekshayam api avidyakhya dosha apekshata eva. So avidya is accepted. As every being is influenced by avidya, therefore avidya itself is a dosha which makes you see the dome shape and the blue color. This is the idea generally. Yasya kasyapi dosha leshasyapi abhave अध्यासस्य असंभवादेव अद्वैत सिद्धौ मधुसूदन सरस्वती दोषजन्यत्वं भ्रमस्य लक्षणम् इति कथितम्। सो यस्य कस्यापि दोषलेशस्यापि अभावे, सो फॉर समवन देयर इज नो दोष, देयर इज नॉट इवन अ लेश ऑफ दोष, लेशस्यापि अभावे अध्यासस्य असंभवात्। Even if you say that not even a little dosha is there, then adhyasa itself is not possible. Therefore, Bhagavan Madhusudana Saraswati Siddhikara Bhagavan Madhusudana Saraswati says in Advaita Siddhi, because of this very reason that adhyasa itself is not possible if there is not even a tinge of dosha. Therefore, he is defined. There is a lakshana given, definition of what? Brahmasya lakshanam. Brahmasya lakshanam kim iti yukte? Dosha janyatvam. Dosha janyatvam is Brahmasya lakshanam. Brahma is basically dosha has to be accepted. Brahmasya lakshana is dosha janyatvam. Therefore, dosham vina adhyaso jayate iti mulokti. Moolokti means in the moola, the statement that dosham vina adhyasa jayeta, that is praudavadina. And what is praudavada? Praudavada is, you know, argument among scholars to showcase their knowledge, that I have a wider knowledge. Panditya is there. Therefore, when argument, if you have better learned, then at least you think that you are better learned, then you bring in other ideas and refute everything, even in Siddhanta. That is every this Bhamati, Vivarna, without compromising Advaita, they can be considered as vadas at the hair splitting level, where either way you can still get to the Siddhanta. Similarly, you go to more detailed levels, there is vada at a tika level, at tippana level, more and more in the same sampradaya without compromising the overall view. So that is praudavada. So here he says praudyartham svavidya khyati svavidya atishaya svavidya atishaya khyapanartham. So there is a khyati being shown. The khyapana, one showcases one's own vidya, saying that I have studied so much, I have inquired into it, so it does not appear right to me, and it is possible in this manner. So that vada kathanam is praudavada. So tena praudavadena ityartha. So here we can see that the sadhu is showcasing his scholarship as, you know, being widely read and inquired into a lot. Therefore, it can be discounted as praudavada. But we should stick on to, because there are very great diggaj people like Madhusudana Saraswati, Siddhikara, and Sharirika Mimamsa also there in the Shankshepa Sharirika also, it has been mentioned. So avidya should be accepted is the idea here. Karanadhyasa nirupanam. Now what is this karanadhyasa? Swayam prakashe api karanadhyasa. In the third point he says, it's an argument, so we'll come to it later. Swayam prakashe api brahmani ajnana upapattihi. So ajnana is possible in Brahma. This is the topic now. Karanadhyasa nirupanam. What is this? There has to be avidya accepted. And avidya or ajnana which is accepted, where is it? It is in Brahma. Now Brahma is Swayam Prakasha and ajnana is tamasrupa, tamorupa. So in this Swayam Prakasha Brahmatma, how can you have ajnana which is tamasrupa? You cannot have. So tamorupa ajnana cannot be in Swayam Prakasha Brahmatma. This is the argument and possibility has to be shown that there is no opposition there. It is possible. Visheshata anavagate vastuni adhyaso jayeta. Where is adhyasa possible? The last point which was made is that in dosha, this argument came up. There has to be a सामान्य ज्ञान विशेष ज्ञान शुड बी मिसिंग. सो ब्रह्म सामान्य ज्ञान शुड बी देयर, ब्रह्म विशेष ज्ञान शुड बी मिसिंग, देन ओनली अध्यास इज पॉसिबल. सो विशेषता अनवगते अज्ञाते वस्तुनि एव अध्यास जायेत, वस्तुनि अध्यास जायेत मींस एंड दैट काइंड ऑफ वस्तु अलोन. सो एवकार कैन बी एडेड. स्वयं प्रकाश स्वरूपत्वाद् आत्मनि अज्ञानम् एव न घटेत. हाउएवर स्वयं प्रकाश स्वरूप आत्मा इज सामान्यता नोन एंड विशेषता आल्सो नोन बिकॉज स्वयं प्रकाश. स्वयं प्रकाश मीन्स दैट इज द विशेष. बिटवीन ऑल सॉर्ट्स ऑफ प्रकाश वस्तुस व्हाट इज दिस विशेष इन ब्रह्मात्मा, इट इज स्वयं प्रकाश. Every other entity has borrowed prakasha, satta also, chaitanya. So prakasha in others, wherever you see prakasha, that prakasha belongs to atma. And atma prakasha is its own. Meaning it is self-effulgent. One, it is not borrowed. Second, self-effulgent means that it is swarupataha prakashavan. So that atma or brahma which is prakashavat, स्वयं प्रकाश सेल्फ एफल्जेंट, हाउ कैन यू मिस इट? यू कैनॉट मिस इट. सो इफ यू कैनॉट मिस इट दैट वैशिष्य वैशिष्ट्य वैशिष्ट्य इज स्वयं प्रकाशत्व दैट इज ऑलरेडी देयर, देन हाउ कैन अध्यास बी पॉसिबल. सो स्वयं प्रकाश स्वरूपत्वाद आत्मनि अज्ञानमेव न घटेत. अज्ञान विच इज तमो रूप कैनॉट बी देयर इन स्वयं प्रकाश सेल्फ एफल्जेंट आत्मा. इट विल टेक अवे द तमः. You cannot have tamas when you cannot have darkness when there is light. Therefore, tayoho anyonyam tamah prakashayor iva virodhat, like being opposed to each other, like darkness and light, you cannot have ajnana and swayam prakasha brahma together. Praudha prakashe sati sarpadhyadhyaso rajvado yathana jayet. तथा सदा स्वयं प्रकाश स्वरूपे आत्मनि बंधाध्यासो अपि न जायेत इति कृताक्षेपः अपि न साधु. सो द आक्षेप विच हैज बीन मेड बाय पूर्व पक्षी दैट यू कैनॉट हैव अध्यास जस्ट लाइक व्हेन देयर इज इंटेंस लाइट, देयर हैज टू बी सम लाइट फॉर रज्जु टू बी सीन, सॉरी सर्प टू बी सीन इन रज्जु. But there should not be Prouda Prakasha. There should not be intense light or, you know, daylight. There should not be so much light that rope is clearly visible. Then only Sarpadhyasa is possible. So Prouda Prakasha Sati Sarpadhyaso Rajvado Yathana Jayeta. Just like it is not possible to see Sarpa in Rajju when there is enough light. Tatha Sada Swayam Prakasha Sarupi. This Swayam Prakasha is Prouda Prakasha Rupa Atma. In that kind of atma, atmani, bandhadhyasa api na jayeta. Bandhadhyasa cannot be possible. It is just impossible because you are always self-effulgent. How can you misunderstand your own swarupa? You cannot have adhyasa. This kind of an akshepa has been made. So krita akshepa is that akshepa which is made that is not sadhu. Api na sadhu. Yadi yadyapi atma alukta swayam prakasha swarupaha तथापि तस्य स्वरूप प्रकाश विल सी फर्दर. यदि यद्यपि आत्मा अलुप्त स्वयं प्रकाश स्वरूप, आत्मा इज स्वयं प्रकाश एंड बाय स्वयं प्रकाश मीन्स ऑलवेज अ साक्षी हियर बिकॉज अलुप्त अलुप्त दृक् से श्रुति. अलुप्त दृक् मीन्स एवर एवर विटनेसिंग एवर साक्षी. अलुप्त दृक् नेवर डज आत्मा मिस एनीथिंग. Now in that kind of an Atma, which Swayam Prakasha, how can that itself be missed? How can you say that I know the entire world, but I don't know myself? Sounds ridiculous. And the Swayam Prakasha, Atma, Chaitanya Rupa, which lends others Chaitanya, sentience, that Atma is not known. Visheshata not known, how can you make that kind of an argument is the Purva Paksha. Yadyapi Atma Alukta Swayam Prakasha Swarupaha Tathapi, even then Tasya Swarupa Prakasha Tasya Swarupa Prakasha Na Ajnana Virodhi. it is not an ajnana virodhi. Swarupa prakasha is not ajnana virodhi. Why so? Here it is shown. Yadi atmana swarupa prakasha ajnana virodhi bhavet. If as per the Purvapakshi, just like light is opposed to darkness, similarly, Atma Swarupa Prakasha, had it been opposed to Ajnana, Tada Sushupto Swayam Prakashatmani Na Ajnanam Upalabhyeta, then one would know oneself even in deep sleep. But does one know oneself? No. One does not claim that I am this kind of a person, I am a man, a woman, just like one does in waking and dream. One does not do that in deep sleep. Sushupto Swayam Prakashatmani Na Ajnanam Upalabhyeta. But one wakes up and says, I did not know anything, I did not see anything. Apitu Gadam Suptottitaha Sukamaham Aswapsam Sukamaham Aswapsam Na Kinchidavedisham Iti Sushupto Swanubhava Siddham Ajnanam Paramrishati. But one inquires and makes a statement, I slept happily, but I did not know anything in deep sleep. I did not know that the world existed. I did not know my body existed. I did not know I existed. I was completely, you know, lights out. How can there be lights out in deep sleep when you are Swayam Prakasha? Due to Ajnana, you have to explain Swayam Prakasha Atma as per Shruti. But Ajnana is there in Sushupti. So it is Anubhava Siddha that Ajnana does veil the Atma. Iti Sushuptau Swanubhava Siddham Ajnanam Paramrishati Sushuptyanubhavasya Vishayaha Sukham Ajnanancha. So Vishaya Sushupti, will just finish this paragraph and stop. I have gone overboard, but let's complete this para. So Sushuptyanubhavasya Vishayaha Sukham and Ajnanancha. Sukha and Ajnana. Sukha, I slept happily, is the experience. And there is Ajnana Anubhava also. I did not know anything. Suptothitasya Jagraddashayam Jayamanam Idam Sukhajnana Vishayakam Jnanam Na Pratyaksham. However, the waker, for the deep sleeper, there is an Anubhava of Sukha as well as Ajnana. But for the waker, it is not Anubhava. The Anubhava Sushuptyanubhavasya Vishayaha, but Natu Jagraddashayam Jayamanam Idam Suptothitasya Jagraddashayam Jayamanam Idam Sukha and Ajnana Vishayakam Jnanam. That there was Sukha and there was Ajnana is not Pratyaksha. It is Anumiti. Aparoksha Vishayakam Hi Jnanam Pratyaksham Ityuchyate. It is not Aparoksha in Jagrat Avastha. But in Sushupti Avastha, it is Aparoksha. Jagrat Kale Saushupta Sukhasya Tadajnanasya Cha Abhavat Tad Ubhaya Vishayakam Jagrat Kalinam Jnanam Na Pratyaksham Kintu Smritihi. Not Anumana, Smriti. It is a recollection. It is a recollection. And what is a recollection? Only that has been collected can be recollected. So it is definitely Aparoksha during Sushupti. But in Jagrat Kala, it is not Pratyaksha. It is not Aparoksha. It is Smriti. It is recollected. So it cannot be called as Anubhava. Why? Because Smriti Bhindam Jnanam Anubhava. It is Jnana alright, but it is not Anubhava now as a waker. It was an Anubhava in the deep sleep. It was collected, and that collected has been recollected, and Anubhava has been collected, and that Anubhava has been recollected as Jnana in Smriti, in waking state, as Smriti in waking state. Sacha Smritihi Anubhuta Vishayini Nasyat Ananubhuta. Sacha Smritihi Ananubhuta Vishayini Nasyat. If there had not been an Anubhuti or Anubhava of that Sukha and Ajnana, you couldn't have recollected. There has to be a collection of Anubhava, only then you can recollect. Ataha Sushuptau Sukha Ajnana Yoho Sukha Ajnana Yoho Aparoksha Jnanam Abhyupagantavyam. Therefore, it has to be accepted that during Sushupti, you had Sukha Anubhava as well as Ajnana Anubhava. Sushuptau tadvishayakam jnanam na eva antakkaranena indriyaischa jayate. And that Anubhava during Sushupti is not collected. The Anubhava is not through antakkarana or indriya. It is sakshi pratyaksha. So antakkaranena indriyaischa na jayate. तदा अंतकरणस्य इंद्रियाणां च सर्वेषां कारणे प्रलीनानां अभावात्। सो अंतकरणस्य इंद्रियाणां च अभावात्, बिकॉज दे आर सर्वेषां कारणे प्रलीना, दे आर ऑल प्रलीना इन कारण। सो कारणे प्रलीनानां सर्वेषाणां, सॉरी प्रलीनानां सर्वेषां इंद्रियाणां। सो अंतकरण एंड इंद्रिया ऑल आर रिजॉल्व्ड इन कारण, देयर ओन कारणस दे आर रिजॉल्व्ड। एंड प्रलीनानां सर्वेषां अंतकरणस्य इंद्रियाणां च अभावात्, दे आर नॉट देयर एनी मोर। इफ दे आर रिजॉल्व्ड यू कैन नॉट क्लेम टू हैव ऑल ऑफ दिस दोस फंक्शनिंग। सो फंक्शनिंग ऑफ इंद्रियाज एंड अंतकरण इज मिसिंग, तस्मात् सुषुप्तौ सुख एंड अज्ञान अनुभव इज देयर। सुखाज्ञानयो अवभासक ज्ञानम स्वयं प्रकाशात्म स्वरूप चैतन्यम एव। देयरफॉर दैट स्वयं प्रकाश आत्मा नोज द अज्ञान एज वेल एज द सुख। प्रकाश ज्ञानम चैतन्यम इति अनर्थांतरम। सो डिफिकल्ट वर्ड हैज बीन यूज्ड, अनर्थांतरम मींस अन्य अर्थांतरम, न अर्थांतरम इति अनर्थार्थम। Difficult to pronounce also, anarthantaram. For me, I mean, it may be easy for others. But what is arthantara? Arthanta is anya artha arthantara. Na arthantara iti anarthantara. So it is not anartha, but it is na arthantara. It is not having different meaning. Meaning what? Prakasha jnana and chaitanya are Prakashah, Jnana, Chaitanya, these are all synonyms. That is all he is saying. So we'll stop here. We'll continue in the this next para, in the next part. Sukham Nityam Swaprakasham Vyapakan Nama Rupyo Adhishtanam Buddhya Bhutam Buddher Dukyatrayamanam Aparam Sarvedanta Vidyam Pratyak Paramah Tadevaham Namatvane Iti Menishchitamatihi Om Tatsat. Any questions? I mean, I've taken a lot of time, but still, if anyone has any questions. Namaste.
Namaste.